What is good, guys? We're here with CL versus Karen's Miss for Ulti round 8. This is a winner's bracket final, so whoever wins this is in grand finals. But yeah, looking at the teams real quick, so probably like Specs or Band, Hooper. I would say Scarf Greninja. And it could be Z-Move Bulu or Z-Move Lando, but I'm thinking Z-Move Bulu. Magma Storm Trend, Taunt Off Power, and then either Toxic or Rocks, depending on if the Rocks are on Lando or on the trend. Both packs are going to be used most likely, the standard set, Toxic Spikes, Recover Haze and Scald. And yeah, the Glisco, if it's Spidef, is going to be nice for Karen in this matchup to help deal with Heatran, because Magmatron is otherwise a really big nuisance for Karen's team. So yeah, we have Bulu versus Bulu here. I assume Karen is just going to switch into Scizor, as it's like one of the best answers that exist for Bulu. And XL doesn't really have the best switch into Bulu. So like, I feel like CL is just gonna stay in. CL is the Zap, Karen just goes into Scizor. So Karen is gonna Bullet Punch here. CL can just go Scizor. I meant Heatran. CL can just go Heatran here. Going for U-turn would be amazing play, but it's too risky. It's early game still, you don't wanna make any too wild plays. So I think Karen is just gonna Bullet Punch. Heatran is gonna come out. But yeah, this is like some semi-stall type of team. And if CL can get up T-Spikes, the Hooper can definitely be a threat in this game. So yeah, just goes in Heatran, let's see. Yeah, Karen just plays it safe. So if this Trent has Rocks, CL can go for Rocks here. As I assume Karen is going to go either the Gliscor or Chansey. Going to Gliscor kind of confirms that it's Spidef Gliscor. I assume this is a knockoff variant with SD, Earthquake and Roost. So what CL can do here is go to Toxapex because the Grassy Terrain is up. So the Grassy Terrain is up, that means that... that Earthquake doesn't do much from Gliscor to Pex, and okay, wow, it was a Jack button, that's interesting. I mean, that's understandable why you would run it on Pex, it's like a pivot type of thing. But yeah, what I was trying to say is, since Grassy Turn was up, Pex was fine, and now CL can go back into Tapu Bulu, because of the... that sets up back the Grassy Terrain. And if it's Z-Move, it also cannot get knocked off, so if it's Z-Move, Tapu Bulu is literally the perfect switch in here. Bulu comes out on a knockoff, and we do confirm it's a Z-Move Bulu. So Karen is going to switch into Scizor here, because Karen wants to defog, right? So if CL can double here into Heatran, that will put... doubling into Heatran here puts you in such a great position, because like, Karen is definitely not staying in because Gliscor cannot touch the Bulu, and Karen wants to get rid of the hazards. CL just plays it safe, I understand that, but doubling into Heatran would have put CL in a really good position early in the game, because Heatran could have gone for Magma Storm then on Scizor if he doubled into Heatran. And then, like, Karen didn't have a good switch, and so yeah, he's just gonna go for Rocks again here. He's gonna go back to Pax, and then the terrain ends, and then he's gonna go back to Bulu. The reason he goes to Pax first, I already talked about it. Grassy Terrain is up, so Earthquake doesn't do much to Pax, and then you go to Bulu after to reset Grassy Terrain. I don't know if I said it already, but I'm thinking this is Scarf Greninja. The Bulu's gonna from Z-Move, so what's the Lando set? Not sure about the Lando set. Like, it doesn't have to be defensive since he has Bulu to deal with Zygarde. So he goes to Pex first and can pivot into Bulu here. The thing is, like, Heatran, like, Karen only has one defogger and Heatran has more Rocks PP than Scizor has defog PP, so like, CL is always gonna keep Rocks on the field in the long run. So yeah, CL can now go into like Hooper or Heatran, but probably Hooper. Hooper puts a lot of offensive pressure on Karen's team, especially with T-Specs up. T-Specs are up at the moment as Karen goes for his own T-Spikes. So I assume we see a Psyshock or a Dark Pulse if it's a Specs Hooper. And if it's a physical Hooper, we're gonna see... like, if it's a banned one, I assume we see a Hyperspace Fury. I assume Karen is just gonna stay in here and go for Recover. Because Pex is so fat, I think it can live any one hit from Hooper. And you wanna scout, if you're Karen, you wanna scout if the Hooper is physical or special. But like, it could be Life Orb mixed, but usually you see Specs or Banded. And yeah, with T-Spike up, it's gonna be really tough for Karen to switch into this. I mean, Pex is gonna take a lot from this hit. It's Dark Pulse, it's Specs, okay. Doesn't get flinch, can recover. So now Karen can go into Chansey here. Because Chansey can take special hits well, we all know this. Chansey has Natural Cure, so even though it gets poisoned, it can still get rid of that. As he gets a crit, and crit plus poison, so Chansey is super low now. So, CL goes goes for the flinch question mark and gets it. I don't know if he went for the flinch. The thing is, he would have stalled out Chansey's softball even if he didn't get the flinch. But yeah, now Karen has to sack the Chansey. Chansey dies to rocks. Like, Karen doesn't have another switch in. Like, if Karen goes hard into Bulu, it will take a lot of damage. So I assume Karen is going to sack Chansey, go to Bulu afterwards. Looking bleak. So now CL is going to go to Lando or Heatran. If Lando is defensive, it's definitely the play here. But yeah, Hooper is definitely amazing in this matchup. Now that Chansey's gone, Hooper crit flinched the Chansey and the T-Spikes just bopped it. And yeah, like the next time Hooper comes in on like Pex again, like it's just gonna be so hard for Karen to switch into. So it goes on the Landris here. Let's see. We do see a Woodhammer do 57. I think that does a little bit too little to be bandit damage. I assume that this is like, it's just a regular Bulu. Like not a damage boosting item. I assume that the Landris just has some sort of speed investment. I assume the Landris is not fully defensive because it took a bit too much damage to be defensive damage, and it took a little too little damage for it to be offensive Lando, if you guys get what I'm trying to say. So I assume that we see, I mean, if Karen is confident that Karen that the Bulu outspeeds, Woodhammer again is a fine play. I guess it could be Scarf Bulu because Karen's team is super slow. Like, I don't really know the item, honestly, but it's not Scarf, okay? Like, I know, like, a lot of people think Scarf Bulu is an unsaid. But yeah, Lando being faster confirms what I was talking about earlier, that, from the damage roll, there was definitely some sort of fast Lando, because the Woodhammer did, like, way too much for it to be of defensive. But yeah, CL goes Pex to absorb the T-Spike. CL can, like, fire off Skulls, try to burn the Celesteela. I assume Karen is just gonna protect to get some lefties. And in the next turn, Karen is gonna go to Pex. Okay, goes to Gliscor. I mean, Gliscor can eat up Skull with ease if it's Spidef, especially. So CL is gonna switch into Bulu again, or just stay in. Yeah, staying in is fine as well, but it doesn't really matter. Yeah, Haze has 48 PP, so like, it's not like CL's Pex gets like PP stall or anything. Just hazing, preventing SD, completely fine play. And when the terrain ends, then going back to Bulu. I understand. I see what CL is doing here. Yeah, I don't see how Karen wins this at this point. What was the Bulu item? I'm guessing it was a Z-move Bulu as well from Karen's side. So it goes on the Celesteela on the SD. I thought it would just Horn Leech. And yeah, CL is gonna switch into Pex or Heatran here. I feel like Karen is just gonna Heavy Slam because there's a plus 2 Bulu in front. But at that point, Karen is in the back, so Karen has to make plays. But even if Karen makes plays, I don't even think there's like a way to come back if CL doesn't choke. Like the Hooper, just whenever it comes in on Pex, like I said earlier, it's like impossible to switch into for Karen without Chansey. So yeah, CL can go Pex here and CL doesn't lose anything. There's the Heavy Slam. So I assume Karen is gonna go for Protect. I mean, Karen can go Gliscor again, but I assume going for Protect is what Karen wants to do to get more leftovers. So now Karen is either gonna Leech Sheet or go into Gliscor. But like, I don't even see how Karen can win this. Like, the Pex Bulu combination, or like Bulu itself, just makes Gliscor useless. And there's no hazards on CL's side, and there's hazards on Karen's side. So it's looking like CL is gonna win game one. So yeah, I would just Horn Leech here, or double into Heat here, and if I was CL, I would probably just Horn Leech at this point. You don't want to play risky, yeah. Like earlier, I was talking about that he could have doubled, but like at this point, he has a big advantage. He doesn't have to make any plays. So I guess, oh, Leech Sheet missed. That sucks, but I don't think it matters at this point. Yeah, I guess you can say that CL made the correct decision in not making the risky play that I suggested earlier, doubling into Heatran. I mean, it would have put him in a better position. But to be fair, he got some hacks. Yeah, the crit on a flinch on a Chansey, that obviously sucked. But it's crazy, when do you ever see Chansey like go down to a special attack? I mean, the T-Spikes obviously and the crit flinch supported that. I mean, CL can like, he's an SD or Horn Leech, or CL can just go into Heatran here. Hooper, yeah, Hooper works as well. I didn't even, yeah. And Steela is gonna go for Protect to Scar, but Hooper locks itself into. I mean, I said Heatran because Heatran doesn't take much from Scald and has Grassy Turin to heal health back, and it can step, like, Nah, Heatran would just force Gliscor in. Never mind. Yeah, I forgot about Gliscor. At first, I thought Karen didn't have a good switch into Magma Storm, and then he could trap the packs with Magmine. But since the Gliscor is still, I think the Gliscor was healthy, right? It was at full, if I recall correctly. So I think it could eat two Magmas. So Dark Pulse didn't protect. For why? Leech Seed, so Karen has to protect now. I assume Cielo is gonna switch out Hoopers, like, valuable. So, like, there's no reason to stay in here, and that says Cielo go back healthy. So double Leech Seeding here would be fire. I understand it's risky, but it would have been fire. But, like, I feel like Cielo's switch was quite obvious. Karen's gonna protect again. Cielo can either Magma Storm here or go back into Hooper, predicting the protect. Goes back into Hooper, there's the protect. Gets more health back from Grassy Terrain. And Karen can protect to scout what Hooper locks itself into, but like it doesn't really matter, yeah. I think Karen is just. It's over. Like, Dark Pulse is gonna claim one. Like, after Protect says Steela might be able to live a hit, but the Hooper just gets a kill. Like, it would 2-hit KO the Steela. And even with Lit Leech, it's not enough. But the thing is, for watching, this was game 1. I'll be back later with game 2 between SCL and Karen Smith's ulti around 8 winners bracket. And yeah. Smash that like button. I'm actually putting in, yeah, like I'm putting in a ton of work for you guys here. I'm doing my best to get all the games for you. And yeah, a lot more Snake content is gonna be coming. Smogon tier playoffs are gonna be coming soon. Stay tuned for that. And let's hope for a good game 2 and potential game 3 as well. And peace out, friends.